In this video, I would like to present how to use the HBM hardware together with ARTeMIS Modal for doing experimental modal analysis using impact testing. In this case here, we have this module here. This is a 16-channel unit. We are only using the first three channels in this. The first channel is the impact hammer that is located here. And then we have two accelerometers here on the last two channels. These are the two ones we see here. So we're going to impact all these locations here on this plate here and obtain in this way the mode parameters of it. The first thing I have to do is I have to define a new project inside ARTeMIS. I do a blank project here. And I have to start by defining a geometry. I have one already lying in a file, a universal file format file that I'll be opening here to get an easy start. So you see all the points are here and the two reference positions are also defined. The next thing I have to do is I have to go to the assigned off information task. And here I have to define the first setup consisting of three channels. The first channel is the impact position or impact sensor that is located here. This is an input channel, so I have to change it to that. I also have to change the direction because we are impacting this direction here. Next channel is an output channel, an accelerometer. This one is pointing in the opposite direction, like this. And the third channel is the same, like this. So this is our first setup, the first impact position together with the two reference locations here. I have to replicate this number of times to make it easy to, you could say, do the same for the rest of these nodes here. So I simply right click here, select the replicate tool, and then I replicate this 15 times. And the only thing I have to do now is actually just to drag out the impact channel here, the input channel, the first one, to the different locations I'm going to impact in. So we have to do this before we can continue. That's it. We have now defined how we would like to do the test, and we are ready now to go to the hardware and connect it. And we choose HBM down here, and then the software is now connecting to the hardware, and we get the list of channels that is available on this unit here. I already have done this test before, so I will simply load the last sensor configuration I had used. This is an easy way to get the different sensors into this list here. Otherwise, you will have to select it through the drop-down list here and select the proper type and so on. But in this way here, we now have a hammer here on the first, and then we have two accelerometers located on the two other channels here. I click OK here, and now we start up the actual acquisition part here. We are now in the impact testing mode, and we have to do different things before we can actually do the actual impact testing. The first thing we can do is we can make an auto assignment. That means that we tell the software that the way that we have defined the project channels is exactly the way, the same way as we have done it for the hardware channels here. So the first channel is hammer, second and third is two accelerometer channels, two output channels. So this is a very simple way to make the link between the hardware and the software. Then we can also add some more displays here so that we can see both the impact in time and frequency domain, the same for the two responses that are coming from the accelerometers. The next thing we have to do now is we have to set up the hammer, the trigger of it. And the first thing we have to do is to select a more proper sampling interval. We will also select some filter that is more appropriate. I would select this one here. And then also resolution, a little bit more resolution in this case here. And then we can try to start it. And I can try to impact so we can get the level of the trigger that has to be used. So I will be tapping a couple of times here in different levels. And as you can see now, we get all these spikes here in the diagram. And there is a stipple line here that actually suggests the level that we should use, the impact level. And this is a 19 Newton in this case here. There is also a pre-trigger time suggested here that I think we'll just keep here. The next we can do is we can set up the windows. In this case here, I like to use, first of all, I would like to see both the raw and the window data. So I choose this option here for the time settings, display type settings. And then the window type for the force will be a force window in this case here. You'll try to avoid to use a window down here at the response part here. Let's see if we can avoid this. We start out and I try to do an impact again.
Triggered.
And she tells us that it's triggered. And as we can see here, we have a nice free decay here that is dying out very nicely here. So no need for any windows on the response side here. Here we have in frequency domain, the force. And down here we have the response. Over here we can see the in time domain the impact. We can also see the indication of where the force window is located. So this looks okay. So we can stop this and then get started with the actual impact testing. So I start simply by clicking
Recording
this button
started.
Here, and now I'll be guided through both by the geometry that it will be. Blinking red, as we can see where I have to do it, but also by a voice that is telling what to do. So I'll start here.
Double hit. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Preparing next setup. Recording started. Double hit. Triggered. 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 Measurement complete. Test is complete.
So now we are complete with the actual impact testing, and it's we can just leave this task here now. We can go to estimation and actually start estimating modes at this moment here. So we can try to use, for example, the RFB set. We can always zoom in a little bit on some of the modes here, and we can try to estimate them like this, and then extract modes like this. So now from here, it's an easy task to get the modes that we want. That's it. Thank you very much.